A man goes to Ali radiallahu anhu and tells him, Ya Ali radiallahu anhu, I find it difficult to wake up at night for prayer. Ali radiallahu anhu, he looks at the man and he says, Anta rajulun qad qayyadatka dhunubuk. You are a man who has been shackled by your sins. Allahu Akbar. If you're finding it difficult to find joy and solace in the remembrance of Allah, if you're finding it difficult to relate to the words of your Maker, if you're finding it difficult to savor and enjoy your salah, and if you find yourself drifting away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you, my brother, my dear sister, you should know that you're being shackled by your sins. Your sins have caused your heart to harden, to become dark. It's weakening you. And it's important that you turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and polish your heart through the remembrance of Allah, through istighfar, through seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Turn to Him, O believers. So now very swiftly I'm going to run through a few benefits that have been outlined in regards to istighfar. And by the way, this is not from my own pocket. This is from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this is from the Quran. Benefit number one. Istighfar is a beautiful way for you to obtain the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in regards to your sins, and it is a means for you to expiate your evil deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says in the Noble Quran in Surah An-Nisa, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ سُوءًا أَوْ يَظْلِمْ نَفْسَهُ ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهَ يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. The one who commits evil or he has wronged himself, ثُمَّ يَسْتَغْفِرِ اللَّهِ, and then he seeks the forgiveness of Allah, يَجِدِ اللَّهَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا. He will find Allah most forgiving, most merciful. The Prophet ﷺ, he mentions a hadith Qudsi. A hadith Qudsi is a narration where the Prophet ﷺ tells us the statements of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but it is not considered the Quran, it is from the ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So Allah Azza wa Jal, he says, يَا عِبَادِي إِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ ظُلْمَ عَلَى نَفْسِي. Oh my slaves, I have made oppression haram upon myself. وَجَعَلْتُهُ بَيْنَكُمْ مُحَرَّمًا. And I have made it haram upon you all as well. فَلَا تَظَالَمُوا. Therefore, do not oppress one another. يَا عِبَادِي كُلُّكُمْ ضَالٌ إِلَّا مَنْ هَدَيْتَ. Oh my slaves, each and every one of you has gone astray. إِلَّا مَنْ هَدَيْتُ. Except the one I have guided. فَاسْتَهْدُونِي أَهْدِكُمْ. Seek guidance from me and I will guide you. يَا عِبَادِي كُلُّكُمْ جَائِعْ إِلَّا مَنْ أَتْعَمْتُ. Oh my slaves, each and every one of you is hungry except for the one I give food, except for the one I feed. Therefore, seek food from me, seek sustenance from me and I will feed you. Oh my slaves, each and every one of you is naked. You do not have clothes except for the one I have clothed. Therefore, seek clothing from me, seek protection from me and I will clothe you, I will cover you. Oh my slaves, indeed you commit sins. You make mistakes in the night and during the day. وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. And I forgive all sins. فَاسْتَغْفِرُونِي أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ. So seek forgiveness from me and I will forgive you all. Allahu Akbar. Seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is commanding us. Seek my forgiveness and I will forgive you. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentions, in another hadith Qudsi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يَبْنَ آدَمْ. O son of Adam, إِنَّكَ مَا دَعَوْتَنِي وَرَجَوْتَنِي فَإِنِّي سَأَغْفِرُ لَكَ عَلَى مَا كَانَ فِيكَ. As long as you call upon me and as long as you have hope in me, I will indeed forgive you of your sins. Even if you were to meet me with sins amounting to this entire planet, بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطَايَا. As long as you meet me having hope in me, having faith in me and having sought my forgiveness, I will forgive you. And then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went on to mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, وَلَوْ عَمِلْتَ مِنَ الْخَطَايَا حَتَّى تَبْلُغَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ مَا لَمْ تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي لَغَفَرْتُ لَكَ ثُمَّ لَا أُبَالِي. Even if you were to come to me with sins reaching the heavens, as long as you have not associated partners unto me, and as long as you seek my forgiveness, I will forgive all of those sins. ثُمَّ لَا أُبَالِي. And I will not look back at it. I will not care about it. These are the words of our Maker subhanahu wa ta'ala. He wants us to seek His forgiveness. So benefit number one, fruit number one, is that by seeking the forgiveness of Allah Azza wa Jal, you are going to achieve the forgiveness of Allah. You are going to have all of your sins erased. You're going to expiate yourself for your sins, for the mistakes that you have done. So that is powerful benefit number one. Benefit number two is that by seeking the forgiveness of Allah, and this is very important, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in today's climate, in today's landscape, by seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are protecting yourself and saving yourself from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah azza wa jal, he mentions in the noble Quran in Surah Al-Anfal, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. So this is in Surah Al-Anfal, ayah number 33, where our Maker subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says that Allah would not punish them whilst they seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whilst you are seeking the forgiveness of Allah azza wa jal, the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to descend upon you. So you are protecting, you are securing the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sins result in the protection of Allah being removed. Sins result in us attracting calamities and punishments towards us. We know of the people of the past and why they were destroyed. They were destroyed because of their sins. They were destroyed because of turning away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to save ourselves from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, turning to Allah azza wa jal, seeking His forgiveness, we protect ourselves. We secure the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So making excessive istighfar secures the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiallahu anhu, he is reported to have said, أَمَانَانِ كَانَ عَلَىٰ عَهْدِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ رُفِعَ أَحَدُهُمَا وَهُوَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ وَبَقِيَ الْآخَرِ. We had two massive protections during the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Two massive covers of protection. One of it has been taken away, and that is our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He has been taken away. That cover of protection has been taken away. The other one remains, and that is al-istighfar, to seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By seeking the forgiveness of Allah azza wa jal, we secure the protection of Allah. In that same ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ. And Allah would not punish them whilst you or Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam are amongst them. وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. And Allah would not punish them whilst they seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu. So whilst we have the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with us, Allah would not punish us. And whilst we seek the forgiveness of Allah azza wa jal, Allah would not punish us. So these are the two covers. Right now we have one cover that is istighfar, that is seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to secure the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Benefit number three, and this is also very much applicable in today's climate, that istighfar is a means for us to relinquish and relieve ourselves of our worries, and to also secure a way out from our problems. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, "Man lazima al-istighfar, the one who holds on to istighfar, ja'ala Allahu lahu min kulli hammin faraja." Allah will make a way out for him from every single worry that he has. "Wa min kulli dhiqin makhraja," and from every difficult situation he will have a way out. "Wa razaqahu min haythu la yahtasib," and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide for this individual from sources unimaginable. From sources unimaginable. The one who holds on to istighfar, your worries are removed by Allah azza wa jalla. Your burdens are eased and lightened. You are given a way out from every single difficulty, and Allah provides for you from sources unimaginable. Man lazima al-istighfar, the one who holds on to istighfar. The next benefit that is in place is that by holding on to istighfar, Allah brings about abundant rain. Rain that benefits, not rain that destroys. May Allah protect us from rain that destroys. Allah brings about rain that is positive and abundant. The proof for this is in Surah Hud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يَا قَوْمِ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ ثُمَّ تُوبُوا إِلَيْهِ يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. O people, seek the forgiveness of your Lord and turn to Him in tawbah. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. And Allah will send down rain in torrents and in showers. وَيَزِدُكُمْ قُوَّةً إِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ. And Allah will take you from strength to strength. Allah will increase our power. Allah will increase our strength and take us from strength to strength. The next benefit that is in place is by seeking forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By seeking the forgiveness of Allah azza wa jal, by holding on to istighfar, you secure the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Surah An-Naml, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَوْلَا تَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Why do you not seek the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala so that you are treated with mercy, so that you may receive mercy?
a rhetorical question is in place in the Quran. Why do you not seek the forgiveness of Allah so that you may receive the mercy of Allah Azza wa Jal? And from the benefits that are in place as well is that Allah will open doors of abundance, wealth and prosperity, and Allah will also bless you with children and bless you with gardens and rivers. There was an individual who went to a scholar, if I'm not mistaken, or one of the Sahaba, radhiyallahu ta'ala alayhim ajma'in, and told him, "Oh, so and so, oh Sheikh, I am in difficulty, as in I am in a lot of debt. Tell me what to do. How am I to come out of my debt, and how am I to secure, you know, provision from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" This Sheikh advised this individual, hold on to istighfar, make excessive istighfar. After a while, another individual comes to the scholar and he says, "Sheikh, I have not been blessed with children. What am I to do in terms of deeds? And can you make, can you please pray that I'm blessed with the children?" The Sheikh then goes on to advise this individual as well, make excessive istighfar in this regard. Now, after these two individuals left, the students who were around this particular scholar, the Sheikh, went on to ask him, "Sheikh, the initial individual who came in, you advised him to make excessive istighfar. He came with a certain problem and your solution was to make istighfar. And this second individual comes to you with a different problem and you advise him as well to make istighfar. So what is the wisdom behind this?" So this Sheikh then went on to read the ayah. فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. In Surah Al-Nuh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, seek the forgiveness of Allah. Make excessive istighfar of your Lord. إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا. Indeed, he is the most forgiving. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. He will send rain upon you in torrents and in showers. وَيُمْدِدُكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ. He will multiply your wealth. By making istighfar, your wealth is going to be multiplied. وَبَنِينَ. And he will bless you with children. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. And you will be blessed with gardens. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. And you will be blessed with rivers. In other words, prosperity, abundance of wealth. By turning to istighfar, by seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as you can see, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we have so many benefits that are in place in terms of istighfar, in terms of seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.